मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैडम.
एवरीबॉडी ओके?
यस मैडम.
ओके ऑलरेडी वी कंप्लीटेड लेसन वन इन द हिस्ट्री. टुडे वी विल सी द सेकंड लेसन इन द हिस्ट्री. सो बिफोर दैट वी विल सी द लास्ट ईयर ऑलरेडी वी स्टडीड अबाउट द हर्षवर्धन. डिड यू रिमेंबर हर्षवर्धन?
यस मैडम.
ही रूल्ड व्हिच पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया?
नॉर्थ पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया.
व्हिच सेंचुरी?
6th सेंचुरी.
Okay, very good children. So in the 6th century, north part of India ruled by the Harshavardhana. Then what happened after Harshavardhana? So in this lesson, we discuss about the 7th century to the 12th century. Today our lesson name is, our lesson in history, second lesson is New Kings and
Kingdoms.
So we will see how. So after Harshavardhana, what happened about the old kings? All the old kings, some places replaced by the new kings. And why they are replaced by the new kings, we will discuss in this lesson. How they were replaced. So here, already you know, the king was supported by?
His subordinates.
Subordinates. So the king was supported by the subordinates. They are called the Samantas. Then who appointed as a Samantas? The king appointed the Samantas if they are... They have landlords. They have more land. Landlords means they have
more land.
Who have the more land like a landlords? And the warriors. Who have the more skill in the war? They are called the
warriors.
So the king used to, he will not select all the subordinates as a Samantas. He will select only few members who are the landlords and who are the war skill, warriors. These people they selected as the Samantas. So what is the work of the Samantas? Which way they will help to the king? So here the subordinates, they help to the king. Suppose that you know already, the kings are, they will want to conquer the other kingdoms. They want to conquer the other kingdoms. So when they are going to the other kingdoms to occupy them, they need the more army support. They need more soldiers. So here during that time, they will ask the subordinates support the with the army support. So they will support with the army. Next one, so here now present, our problems, who will solve?
Government.
Yeah, government. Present we are the democracy government. So our people solved by the government. But olden days, like this democracy is there, not there. We are ruled by the rulers.
Kings.
We are ruled by the
rulers.
Kings. So then how the people's problems were solved? So here Samantas, they are the particular region. So in the particular region, any problem is there, then they will carry forward to the king's court. Otherwise, sometimes people also will attend the king's court to say their problem. So here, the Samantas, they will attend the king's court to solve the people problems. Next one, during festival time. You know the festivals, no? We'll celebrate festivals, no? So here, during the festival time, the Samantas take the gift to the king. So the work of the Samantas is, here they will help the king by the soldier support. Next one, in the court session, they will attend the courts. Next one, they will do, give the gifts to the kings. This is the work of the Samantas. Like this, the Samantas helping to the kings in different way. So when they are continuing so many years, now they will become very powerful. The Samantas will become very powerful. So here in return, what the king will give to the Samantas? They are helping to the king now. Then what he will give to them? So here what the king will say? So here a particular place, they allotted a particular place to the Samantas. They allotted the particular place. In this region you are the subordinate. Suppose we will take example of one particular area. He is the Samantas of that particular area. So what is the tax in that area? Samantha will collect the tax and some amount he will spend to his maintaining soldiers, no? For that he will maintain the soldiers. That one he will take the money, tax, from the tax. Then remaining amount he will send to the king. He will send to the king. Like this, when the few years like we have like a Samantha, now they got more money. Now they became
Mahasamantas.
They became wealthy person. So when the Samantas became more power and wealthy, then themselves they are declared as a Mahasamantas. They are declared themselves as a
Mahasamantas.
Mahasamantas means I have the great power. I have more money, wealthy person. So like that they are declared. Like this, themselves the Samantas declaring Maha Samanta, Maha. So when the Samantas became Maha Samantas, Maha Mandaleshwara, now they want to gain the power. They want to gain the kingdom. They want to rule the kingdom. How it is possible? So here, the wonder is after the king, who will become the king?
His son or his daughter?
Son. His son. So his son or daughter, who is there? So here, this is this process is called hereditary process. This process is called hereditary. Hereditary means after that king, his family members will become the new king. Like this is there. So here the Samantas, what they are observing, if any king, son, after him, they are not that much powerful like a king. They are overthrowing this king from the kingdom. Then they are declaring themselves as a king of that particular region. So like this, the Samantas became the kings, new kings. They became the new kings for the particular kingdoms. Now see, let us few examples here. Now see few examples in India map. See here, India map is there. Now see here few examples. This is the northwest part. This pink color is there, no? This pink. This pink is the northwest. So this northwest, the kingdom is the Gurjara Pratiharas. The rulers, the dynasty is the Gurjara Pratiharas. Now see the green color here. This is which direction? This is
east direction.
Very good. This is the east direction. So here east direction, Pala dynasty. This place is occupied by the Pala dynasty. Now see yellow color here. Yellow color, can you see? This area is called Deccan area. Deccan means what? It is a deck. Already you know Deccan plateau, you know, children? So this is called Deccan area. So this Deccan area, the kingdom is Rashtrakutas. The kingdom is dynasty is called Rashtrakutas. Now here you can see the white part. This is which king's kingdom is there? Chola kingdom. This is the Chola kingdom. So here we can see these four dynasties. We can see these four dynasties. Gurjara Pratiharas, pink color is Gurjara Pratiharas, green color is Palas, yellow color is Rashtrakutas, next one is Cholas. Now will you compare this dynasties with earlier dynasties? You know the dynasty, meaning of the dynasty, children?
Yes, teacher.
Let us see here. Dynasty means the kingdom ruled by the same family long time. That is called the dynasty. Already we know the Mauryan dynasty. Already you know Mauryan dynasty?
Yes, teacher.
Who is the famous king in the Mauryan dynasty?
Harshavardhana.
Ashoka.
Ashoka.
Ashoka. Ashoka is the famous in the Mauryan dynasty. So Mauryan dynasty, it is a vast dynasty. So these four dynasties, not that much vast like a Mauryan dynasty. So they are the only small area they are confined. Now we'll see these dynasties, the rulers, they are the earlier Samantas. How they established this new dynasties? We'll see example. Now we'll see this Rashtrakuta dynasty. This is the Rashtrakuta kingdom. This is the Rashtrakuta kingdom. Now here, this Rashtrakuta dynasty, the founder is Dante Durga. Now see, these three examples we will discuss now here. Rashtrakuta, this dynasty was, the founder is the Dante Durga. So this Dante Durga is the Samanta to the Chalukya kings. He is the subordinate to the Chalukya kings. Then what happened to the Chalukya kings? Why they did not, next forward king did not come, means here they are not that much before like that king, they are not that much strong. So the Dante Durga, he overthrew his Chalukya's king, then he became the king. Now he want to declare himself as a king of that Rashtrakuta dynasty. Then how it is? So by birth he is not a Kshatriya. You know the Varnas, no, children? The people were divided into Varnas, no?
Yes, teacher, there are.
How many Varnas were there?
Four Varnas.
What are the four Varnas?
Brahmana Varna, Kshatriya Varna, Vaishya and Sudras.
Okay, then what is the work of this Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Sudras?
So Brahmins, they teach, they learn stuff whereas Kshudras, they fight in the wars. Vaishyas, they work as businessmen. And Shudras, they do our work, such as foot work.
Okay, children. So here, Kshatriyas means they will rule the people. So this Dantidurga, by birth, is not a Kshatriya. Then he want to become Kshatriya, what to do? For that, he did the one ritual that is called Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha, if he will do this ritual, then he will rebirth as a Kshatriya. Then he has the right to rule the people. This Hiranyagarbha also called golden womb, means rebirth. Again, he will get the rebirth as a Kshatriya. Like that, this Dantidurga became the powerful in the Rashtrakutas. He is the founder of the Rashtrakuta dynasty. Next, one more example we will see. Kadamba dynasty. Mayuri Sharma. He belongs to the Kadamba dynasty. He established the Kadamba dynasty. Next one, Harichandra. He also established the Pala dynasty. So by nature, these two are not the Kshatriyas. They are the Brahmins. By birth, they are the
Brahmin.
So they have more war skills. They are very good in the war. That's why they overthrow their kings and they themselves declared as their kings. So like this, the new kings establish their kingdoms. Now we'll see the administration. How they rule the people. How they rule their kingdom. So that is called the administration. So here, when these Samantas, now they became the kings, no? When they have the great power, themselves they declared as the Maharajadi Raja, means great king. Maharajadi Raja. Otherwise, Tribhuvana Chakravarti. Tribhuvana Chakravarti. Three means how many?
Three.
So here, Tribhuvana means three worlds. He was the king of the three worlds. Like that, themselves they gave the titles. Maharajadi Raja, Tribhuvana Chakravarti. Now this one administration, how they administrate their kingdom. So here, now present we see our country India. Who is the Prime Minister now?
Narendra Modi.
Narendra Modi can see all the...
No, he
cannot see all the Indian people. So then what he did?
He shared the power.
Otherwise, we will take the best example in our school. Now, who is the head of the school?
Principal madam.
Very good. Principal madam. So, principal madam cannot see the problems, cannot solve the problems of the students at a time. Okay. So, what they did? They divided the, shared the power. They shared the power to the their subordinates. They shared the power to the subordinates, to the class teachers. Again, class teacher shared his some few powers to the class leader. When she was in the absent, then absence means she will go to another class like that. She work given to the class leader to maintain the silence in the classes. Like that, the power distributed. Here, Samantas were also, these kings also, they distributed the power among the Samantas. And power given to the farmers, association of farmers. Association means group of the farmers. And some given to the Brahmins, like the traders. Some power given to the traders. So in their administration, the power, the kings distributed the power among to the subordinates, Brahmins, association of farmers and traders. So like this, they distributed the power and they are ruling the people. Now king want to rule the people, he required, so, now the government is there, present government is there. How the government is ruling us? They need the money. Government need the
money.
To see the administration of the, they need the money. Then how they get the money, present government how?
Tax. They collect taxes.
They collect the taxes from the people. So they are providing us the facilities like health facilities, education facilities, like that they are providing the facilities to us. So here old land is also, the king has to provide some facilities to the people. What type of facilities he has to provide? He has to protect the people from other kings. So here old land is, the kings, they want to occupy other kingdoms. That time they required the protection. They required the
protection.
For that purpose, here they have to protect the people. Then what to do to protect the people?
They have to collect tax.
They have. So how to do this protection means, they have to construct the port. You know the port means? What is the port? Port means around the kingdom with the strong wall. With the strong wall they will construct. That is called the port. So here, these are called the massive constructions. These are called the massive construction. Massive construction means it takes more money. Power, more money, and it required the manpower also. It required the
manpower also.
To construct these massive constructions like ports, palaces, temples. Why they want to construct palaces, children?
So that the king and his family can live.
Very good. Palaces are the residence to the royal people. Palaces are residence to the
royal people.
Then why they constructed the temples?
So that everybody can go to a place and worship.
So here sometimes the king want to show his powerful. How much I am power? How much I am power? It shows to the power to other kings. Then he want to construct big temples. If you will go to South India, you can see number of temples, large temples. They are very large temples. So here the king collected the money in the form of the taxes. That money is used to construction, massive constructions like forts, temples, palaces. Then he want to maintain the soldiers, no?
Yes, yes.
Yes, he has to maintain the soldiers. Then after to maintain the soldiers, to soldiers what he has to give?
Money.
So salaries. He have to give salaries. Salaries, otherwise they have to provide the food. They have to provide the food. Okay. So to maintain the kingdom, administration. To maintain the kingdom for administration, otherwise to maintain the soldiers, otherwise to construct the massive constructions, already we discussed. And see here, the kings wear jewelry, no? You saw any time?
Yes, teacher.
We are seeing in the serials also, no? TV serials. The king means one big appearance we can see. Everything he will wear, these ornaments here, this, everything he will wear. So here, we can identify the queens also with the lot of the jewelry. So this all also from this taxes of money only they will do. So here, next one here, how they collect these taxes? Now present, how we are giving taxes to the government in the form of?
GST, money.
In the form of?
Money.
We are giving the taxes to the government in the form of the money. Then imagine old land is like this, money is there?
No, teacher.
This much money, currency.
No, teacher.
So here, in the form of how they are collecting the taxes means, here suppose traders are there, they are doing the business, they will get the money. Suppose farmers are there, what they will do farmers?
They grow crops.
Crops. They will grow the crop, they are producing the grains. They are producing the grains. Next, artisans are there. What they will produce artisans? Suppose potter is there, he will make the pots. Carpenter is there, he will do the carpentry work. Like this, they are doing artisans in their work. Next one, here, so the farmers, they are producing the grains. Traders, they are through business, they are getting the money. Next one, artisans, they are doing different artisan works. They are getting the products. Okay. And cattle traders. Cattle traders, what they will give the output?
Milk
products, like this wool, meat, like this they will get it. So the king, how we collected the tax means, what they are producing. Now we will discuss different type of people now here. From this different type of the people, what they are producing, from that produce, some part of the produce they have to give to the king. That one he will use to the maintain the kingdom. Okay. Suppose carpentry is there. Then what he will produce, he will give. Otherwise, during the massive construction, without taking the money. So he will support. He will carpenter. Suppose one building is there, one palace is there. It requires the carpentry work. It requires the help of the carpentry. So like this, that is the tax. Imagine that is the tax. Suppose here during the festival time, king used to pay the people free. Food he will give. All the tax they are giving. Okay. So now also government has providing free food now. So yes, some government is providing free. Some governments they are taking 5 rupees like that they are providing. So in olden days also during ritual time, any festival time, the king used to provide the food to free food to the people. So this grains, what he is getting, grains from the farmers or milk products like this. This is taxes he is collecting and is administrating the kingdom. So here the things we saw now how they established the kingdoms. How they established the kingdoms. Next one we saw the how they are administered the kingdom. Now we see next one is prashastis. Prashastis and the landmass. The topic is prashastis and the landmass. What is the prashasti? What is the prashasti? Did you visit any temple, children?
Yes, teacher.
So in the temple you can saw that walls on the wall that we write now. The donations given by different people, different donations. Anytime you saw?
Yes, teacher.
Sometimes they will write about the god also you saw?
Yes, teacher.
On the walls.
Yes.
So, like that on the hard surface, on the hard surface, they will write about the king. They will write about the king. Okay. They will praise the king. Sometimes the king only ask the learned people. Learned people means here Brahmins. They know to write Brahmins. So, they will ask the Brahmins to write about themselves.
Prashastis.
On the hard surface, they will write about the king. What they will write? Means about the family, what the dynasties from. Suppose we will take the Mauryan dynasty. Who established the Mauryan dynasty? Chandragupta Maurya.
Maurya.
After Chandragupta Maurya, who became king? Next, after who? Like this, one by one, they are important kings. In the dynasty, they won't mention all the kings who are very famous. Who see the welfare of the people, that kings they will mention in the prashasti. So, about their family and how he is a very powerful king, how much he is a powerful, and sometimes he will go to other things to occupy now. So, he is victorious in which kingdom, what victory in which year he victorious that kingdom occupied by him. Like that, the praise, they will praise the king. Sometimes king only will ask the Brahmins about his achievements to write on the prashastis. So like that the prashastis were written by the, who written this prashastis?
Brahmins.
Brahmins. To whom?
Kings. To praise the kings.
To praise the kings they wrote the prashasti. So for this return they gave the land grants. So the kings in return to the Brahmins they gave the
land grants.
Land grants. So that is called land grants. Now you see here in the prashasti, they are praising the king and they are writing. So here Kalhana. Kalhana, he belongs to North India. He belongs to
North
India. So in his book Raja Tarangini, he wrote in the 12th century, he criticized the kings. So every prashasti they are praising the kings. But Kalhana, well, sometimes we can see the kings, they will do good for the people. Sometimes, suppose if you say, see the Ashoka. So in his war, Kalinga war, you know?
Yes, teacher.
Kalinga war. After the Kalinga war, he gave up the war. In future, myself, my generation, my son, they won't do the war. Why he himself realized?
Because of the bloodshed
Because of the bloodshed he saw in the Kalinga war, he witnessed that man. So to win the people, kingdom, I am giving this much loss to the people. He realized that. So like this, the Kalhana criticized some kings also. In which book he criticized? Raja Tarangani. He criticized in his book Raja Tarangani. So Kalhana wrote Raja Tarangani in the 12th century. He criticized the Kashmir kings. He criticized the
Kashmir kings.
Okay, so here prashasti are saying praising the kings, not only praising the kings, some they criticized the kings also. Now here we are saying that the kings gave the land grants to the Brahmins. We are saying land grants are given to the Brahmins. So here, now have the same present. Suppose you have own house, otherwise you have the own car. Then how it is the proof you have the own car, you have the house?
Documents.
Documents. You saw any time documents of your house?
No, teacher.
Car documents?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. So here, when we have our own, we have some property means we have the documents written on our name. They will give the document. So if anybody will come, this is my house, leave it means we can show. Proof is there. Okay, like that. So here, when they gave the, donated the land to the Brahmins to authorize authentication. So anybody cannot come and occupy that land. So this one king, they wrote on the copper plates, this land, the boundaries. He marked the boundaries, and among these boundaries, this land belongs to this Brahmin. I donated to this Brahmin. This land grants cannot collect tax. So here Samantas are collecting land, taxes on the lands, no?
Yes, teacher.
So what is land grants given to the Brahmins? Here one more exemption also is there. So tax was not collected in this type of land. So this all mentioned on the copper plates. This all mentioned on the
copper plates.
So here Brahmins, how much land given? The boundary they mark, and they gave to, they mention on the copper plates, that copper plates given to whom?
Brahmins.
Given to the
Brahmins.
These are called the land grants. These are called the
land grants.
So here, till now, once you see till now, what we learn? Summarize. Okay, we'll summarize. Till now, what we learn?
We learnt about Samantas.
Yes.
Mahasamantas.
Yes.
How they take over the kingdoms.
Okay, very good.
And we learned about Danti Durga, Hiranyagarbha, and how what are Prashishtas.
Okay, Chinna. So here in this lesson we studied about how these kings became occupied the new kings. So themselves what they declared the titles, Maharaja, Viraja, Tribhuvana, Chakravarti, how they share the power, then to admin, rule the kingdom, what the taxes they collected, how the taxes was collected, and how this tax was spent, how this tax was
spent.
So this all mentioned in the Prashastis, about the kings mentioned in the
Prashastis.
So in return, the Prashastis, they gave to the land grants to the
Brahmins.
Okay, Chinna? If any doubt is there, you can ask now. So I am giving the task of the day, means you have to read the lesson thoroughly. What I explained in the textbook, okay, you read thoroughly. And if any doubt is there, you circle that one and tomorrow you can ask in the class. Now I am giving the task, okay. So he did the Hiranyagarbha, no? Danti Durga?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so in which year he did this one? In which year he became the king of the Rashtrakuta? Okay, you can find out that one. Next one here, Prashastis we mentioned, no?
Yes, teacher.
So some Prashastis are there. Okay, achievements of Nagavatta. Achievements of Nagavatta. It is available in Gwalior in the Madhya Pradesh. You see that one. You collect the information. You
of Nagavatta.
Nagavatta achievements. Nagavatta
achievements.
In that Prashasti, what they mentioned. You collect the information. Okay. Next one, you collect the information of, I mentioned four dynasties now. Palas, Rashtrakutas, Gujar Pratiharas, Cholas. So these four dynasties you locate in the India map. You locate in the
India map.
One more thing you have to do. Suppose you are belongs to your state, your area. Okay. Belongs to which dynasty? To write it. I am the particular state. So this state was ruled by this particular
dynasty.
You have to find out.